I have to stay here for the micro. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Annaberg gefällt mir sehr gut hier.
I'm here for the first time in Annaberg. It's very nice here. Now it's about communication, how do journalists convey the messages of what we understand by weather and climate. Early April, I met several members of the Rotary Club, where I belong to. We considered the book 10 Billion by Stephen Emmett. I don't know if you know it. And we spoke about climate change. And one member actually stood up and had a cutting, a newspaper cutting in his hand, and said, how about climate change? There are a lot of doubts about it. Several days ago, end of March, the FAZ news newspaper said that an economist from the Netherlands left the meeting, one of the meetings around the third Climate Council report. So he didn't want to be forced to dramatize the economic results of and impacts of climate change. There is a lot of uncertainty. What do you think? So if even the experts of a panel do not agree. I was the only meteorologist in the circle. So I was asked more or less because I was the only one knowing more about. So we always have to remember this was one scientist out of 400 scientists. And normally the newspaper, it's a big newspaper, an all-German newspaper, they should have also published the statements of the other 399 scientists in order to convey an objective image of what actually happened. And that's one of the problems of communication in general. We had an opinion poll among journalists, and this is good also for the debate, for the climate change debate, showed that 90% were convinced of that we are actually exposed to climate change currently. Only 1 out of 10 actually was skeptic and did not agree. Out of the 90%, actually said they want to, 70% out of the 90% wanted to have a balance between skeptic voices and supporting voices. They wanted to hear both of them, especially according to Brüggemann, who was the initiator of the opinion poll. So that's a general topic for the journalist, how to take in information, how to give it out. At least we have, for communication, we have two sides, two people, two counterparts communicating with one another, whether with words or without words. There are two human beings, different human beings. A man, somebody living in the savannah of Africa, when reading or hearing big tree, he actually will have the notion and concept of a baobab, a big tree storing water in the trunk, having few branches, but a child, let's say from Annaberg, from the Central European, might see a spruce tree. Who knows? When we were very little children, we actually learned to make a link between notions, concepts, ideas, and the words we use to designate them. And it's an error to believe that the person beside you actually understands the same thing under this, with the same words, because we all have our individual experience with the environment. We develop our senses, emotions, and ideas. And we also have to remember it's not just about information, but there are other interactive processes. Do I like the other one? Is there a good smell? Do you feel convenient on the side of your current neighbor? These are very interesting criteria we also have to consider. Am I a good listener? Do you actually, for example, I speak to you, do you like my outer appearance, eyes, hairs, my jacket? 75% of information is interpreted individually by the person accepting. That means even for the presentations held here, are accepted and understood differently from one person to the other. And what is astonishing in the end is that it's not a question about being conscious and aware of that, but it's a matter of subconscious. It is like driving. Once you learn it, you do not actually consider the actions you do, braking or speeding up or whatever. So there's a lot of intuition and subconscious where you even do not need to think about it. So it's a kind of storage of what we learned beforehand. And there's another cliff we have to avoid. So we have awareness does cost much more energy than the subconscious. Reasoning is very, very bothersome. We spend energy, we need carbohydrates. I hope you ate well, maybe you ate too much. Then, of course, you normally have now a lot of action in your stomach and not in your head. So for those coming after me, I'm sure they did not eat too much in order to be well awakened soul. That means when listening attentively to me, then please eat what you have on you, whatever it is, a slice of bread or a Snickers, so I then know that you are actually listening carefully. So how to contact the public on behalf of a journalist, of a politician? My subject is, of course, the weather report, the weather forecast. And so what is the impression I arouse in the people listening to me? Many spectators, when seeing our studio, our virtual studio, are actually lost. This is where we produce, more or less, our weather forecast, at least. A lot of lamps, it's virtual, a green background, because the green will be removed and will be replaced electronically by the picture that you as a spectator will see later on. On the platform, you will see Mrs. Slomka, the presenter, in order to raise her in comparison with the others. Then you see the weather map in the background, Mrs. Hornifer. That is how we actually act, stand in front of our weather map. You see this. I, of course, can see that also in a monitor in order to have a certain orientation. But that's how it looks really. So that means what we see there, this monitor, is just for our orientation. In order to handle, to access and cope with the empty room, the empty space, because it's actually an empty space, and we'll be replaced and items will be inserted artificially. So where am I in my text?
Zurück zur Wetterkarte.
Let's come back to the map.
Das Problem beim Wetter ist ja eigentlich, es ist
the problem with the weather is that we have local variation, very local, highly specific, and also a dynamic evolution. That means the weather changes while going on, and we cannot say weather actually crosses from one point to the other. Spectators might think, because it would be easy to understand, but most people are overwhelmed by the idea.
Und wenn man das Wort Sonnenschein hört,
for example, sunshine,
dann ist man dann vielleicht überzeugt,
then you might say, ah, you said sunshine, not only at the coast in the north, at the Baltic Sea, but also in the main Rhine area. And then you might be disappointed the next day when seeing the weather around you. Up to now, the Climate Council actually had good publications. In 2009, almost 70% were concerned about future climate. But in the last year, there was a decrease to less than 40%. Are there new findings that climate change has gone? Is there too much information conveyed? Maybe it's a kind of getting bored of the subject. The Earth is still turning round, and actually nothing has actually happened. But, as already said, events are local, drought, floods, as we already heard. That's the big issue. To have the idea of the 30-60 years perspective in the future.
Many people, I too,
we are not able to understand a threat occurring in 50 years and feedback for our today's action. So let's push it aside. The politicians will actually find a good way to get out. But we must see they are wired in the same way as we are. They are not wiser or more intelligent. And we have small-scale climate models, as you can see, as we have just seen. One of the reasons why we disagree with climate change is that there are a lot of contradictory messages competing with one another. Today, Mr. Hume said, visualization maybe for us.
Schon das Erleben einer kühlen Periode im Sommer,
even the, when we experience a cold period in summer, many people think, oh, no climate change, then there might be a mild winter and with next spring rather wet. Then we do not actually understand. We want it simple. The public wants it simple. Every year, from year to year, a slight increase, then it's okay. So what is the best way to convey the message, the information? We have TV, newspapers. Are there actually working mechanisms to do it well?
Visuelle Informationsvermittlung
visual
läuft schneller als lesen.
Information is quicker than reading, and we currently experience a world of pictures. A picture says more than 1,000 words, as we say. So TV, for TV it's pictures, for newspapers it is brief messages, headlines, and so we must admit there is no such thing as objective information. Of course, the information may be factual and scientific, but it will have a context and also subjective connotations. I have several brought along several examples of our.
First,
you can.
Let's
just stop your picture.
I'm very sorry, I cannot.
Okay, and now you stopped your
picture.
I'm very sorry.
Could you remind me of something?
Mancherorts wurden gefühlte Temperaturen von bis zu 50 Grad minus.
Paging through you.
Südamerika hingegen eine brüllende.
So there is a mix of channels, as we can see, information not well conveyed. Maybe let's wait for a minute in order, because normally you should listen to the sound, or it's very tricky to fix it, yeah. But let's try. So it was the beginning of a TV news show. And
also es geht darum,
die eisigen Temperaturen in den USA, sie haben auch Einfluss auf unser Wetter. Eine sogenannte
Okay, I'm going to translate afterwards. Yeah. Let's resume.
Guten Abend, bevor wir zu den politischen Themen des Tages kommen, reden wir über das Wetter.
Before speaking about politics, let's first of all speak about weather. We have a lot of heat, a long period of heat here. It's not extreme, but on the other hand, on the other side of the Atlantic, there are record temperatures. Temperatures as cold as not experienced during 20 years, less than 50 degrees Celsius in South America. America,
hotspot
in Rio de Janeiro, for example, when entering the airplane and leaving the airplane in Florida, then you will have a difference of about 80 degrees Celsius. So this is a felt, the temperature we feel, and the temperature is measured. 80 degrees difference in the summer. But we of course, you see, also you should know that in the Northern Hemisphere you have summer, you have winter time and summer in the southern Minnesota, in the US, small town, minus 40 degrees Celsius were measured, less than 50 are expected by weather experts, and the icy temperatures in the US, they actually will have an impact onto our weather. There's a wave.
Was ist eigentlich passiert in diesem
What
Jahr im Winter?
Did die actually happen in the winter?
Hat sich sozusagen im Norden gesammelt in der Arktis.
Actually accumulated in the Arctic region, minus 20 to minus 50 degrees Celsius, but it will find its way to south, that's the normal way, and it went, it passed through the US and partly through Siberia. And of course we will have counter flows, and that's where we are located. Yeah, well, there was no winter at all, but in the US we actually have very low temperatures, a new blizzard is expected in the region of New York. You see, the limited possibilities we have for explaining, how to explain in such a short time, how there is an exchange of air masses, of air flows. It might be a first attempt to give some kind of explanation why there is such a big difference between heat in Europe and very low temperatures and others. But the information has to be shortened down, cut down.
Wurde überhaupt nicht gemeldet. Woran lag das?
There was one depression, there was one tempest. We actually told our news show we should speak about it, but they didn't actually have it in the program. They said our agenda is full. We don't. There is no problem, no calamities, no casualties. So, but then the tempest came, and it actually was introduced at very short notice in a very brief message. During the afternoon, I told them 170 kilometers per hour speed already. We should do that. We have an information, but they didn't want. But then later on, early December, Sava
überfluten im Jahr 1962 Hamburger Stadtteile. Die Menschen werden im Schlaf überrascht.
Flood,
für die größte Naturkatastrophe der Nachkriegszeit gab es keine Vorwarnung. Schon Tage
after
zuvor
World War II
ein heftiger Sturm über Norddeutschland. Aus ihm wurde ein gewaltiger Orkan. Innerhalb weniger Stunden waren tiefer liegende Stadtteile wie Wilhelmsburg völlig überflutet.
Part of the city like Williamsburg were flooded entirely. People had to climb onto the roof. Many people did not succeed in escaping. 200 people died within the first minutes of the flood. A lot of dikes actually broke. Hundreds of thousands were enclosed by water. 315 people died in total. In 1999, Lothar,
und auch in den Rheinauen
the Lothar Tempest causes windfall in a large area. People have to stay in their cars overnight. Houses are destroyed. 13 people die.
Der Orkan Kyrill im Jahr 2007 Cyril als ein Jahrhundertsturm bezeichnet werden.
It's also likely to be considered a century event.
The
scaffoldings broke down. Ship crews had to be saved, rescued. Cars were destroyed. No railway. Flights are very risky at the moment. Airplanes like leaves in the wind.
Es dauert bis zu einer Woche, bis die
and electricity overhead lines were partly
ist.
Cut by the tempest. Posts were broken down. 47 people died throughout Europe.
Vielen in Erinnerung ist noch Sturmtief Christian diesen
and
Oktober
might
auch
also
in Hamburg.
Be part
Christian
of the
erreichte Spitzengeschwindigkeiten von 190 Stundenkilometern. Ähnlich stark
velocity.
Könnte nun auch Xaver
and
auf die Nordseeküste
now,
treffen.
Might now have the same impact. 190 kilometers per hour. It was measured in Denmark, not in Germany, so we actually exaggerated. But the pictures, of course, are fascinating. I think that's, and we are well prepared now for what Xaver might actually cause. That was the intention, is the intention, because tension, suspense in the people. For Xaver, people went to the North Coast. We had reporters on the spot. and it was part of the concept of the news show.
Land unter auf Hallig.
Nee, das lassen wir mal aus.
But let's skip that.
Das ist ja wahnsinnig. Wir kommen aus der Schweiz.
We're from Switzerland. And such wind, almost impossible to stand.
Von Schottland das sheer folly. Xaver über die Nordsee gekommen. Mit seinen Orkanböen zieht er über den gesamten Norden Deutschlands weiter bis nach
passes over north of Europe. So this was the beginning, and it was meant to have smiles on the faces of the people. And this is now our map.
Ob der Zuschauer weiß, dass das tatsächlich die stärksten Böen sind, wage ich zu bezweifeln. Für mich ist es
I dare doubt that it's a zero information. I think people are not able to understand the map without any explanation, but they decided to insert it. Russia, this truck in Germany, in the north of Germany, cannot withhold. Oh, it's kind of a shock. I come from a country with 35 degrees Celsius. In Oldenburg, 15 minutes delay, a tree fell down. I'm coming from Cologne. We want to go to Kiel, but we cannot go on. These original voices are always well accepted by the people. We had a certain special experience, eyewitnesses, visible, so to say. And this raises the interest, arouses awareness.
This is another attempt.
Hamburg tells us that the Authority for Internal Affairs and Sports announces high tide 5.60 meters above zero will be the level. We were both together. And somebody told us 2 minutes before it started, for 5.6 meters, I didn't consider what is the current level. We had, this was a new information, how to insert it, how to include it in any way. Low-level areas in the harbor, in the port should be left. Please protect your property, and local radio station should repeat that.
Yes, I think it will
remember 1962. It's almost the same level as in 1962. It was a bit almost 6 meters. What's the danger? First of all, we have the moon. The gravity from the moon raises the wave around the Earth. And on the other hand, we have another constellation. Sun, moon, and Earth are in a line, which accumulates the gravity and raises even more the tidal wave. And then we have the tempest from the sea, which actually raises once more the peak of the tidal wave.
So
if listening, it's about tomorrow, 7 o'clock in the morning, and I speak about a line, who can actually understand? There might be a misunderstanding, because in this case, you cannot explain the second wave on the other side of the Earth. You can an explanation in TV should always be simplified and facilitated. It's always incomplete of what actually happens. My conclusion is that as a spectator, you're mostly fascinated, you're exposed to the pictures, exposed to the information. In a certain way, you are, it's kind of cheating, because it's not the actual picture, but with a good intention. We had a report in Hallighoge, a small island. We bought several things, especially grain, corn, schnapps, yeah, in order.
So,
when being a partner in an interview, then you should know your journalist. You should have an idea of his or her intentions.
Sie kennen oder Sie wissen, wenn Sie aus dieser Gegend kamen,
you might know
vor 2 Wochen gab es hier ein schweres Gewitter.
2 weeks ago there was a thunderstorm here,
ZDF einen kleinen Bericht machen.
And we wanted to have a small report.
vorgelegt.
Five questions were submitted to me. One question, we speak a lot about dry periods, is there less rainfall, but now such a thunderstorm, how to explain? What are the impacts of the dry weather onto the environment? Do we have to reckon with increased frequencies of such events? What are the risks of such thunderstorms and rainfalls? And will be the dry period soon be over? We answered that, and that was the result. That is the result of what was shown. There's something going on over Markersbach. People run home. The Erzberger region sees a heavy thunderstorm, heavy rainfall, like a lot of rain onto the dry soil, which cannot absorb the waters. Sludge slides into the village. Oh, there was a thunderstorm from Langenberg. Pave stones were carried along, not water, for our house was renovated, and now we are very angry because this sludge tends to be cemented on our doors. The second time we experienced this. Ah, then let's work. And the brown sows entered almost everything, backyards, and now no snow in winter, but now it can be used for sludge. Basements have to be emptied of water. First of all, many people enjoyed the rain because it was such a dry period, and now so much at once. If there are heavy rainfalls in form of thunderstorms, then we have the problem, more runoff, and the soil cannot absorb the amounts of water, and then smaller streams will become kind of rivers and will carry along everything and risk. Fire teams and rescue brigades had to clean up the city.
Good. Das heißt, wenn ich Interviewpartner bin,
when being an interview partner,
gesagt,
as already said,
die Absichten des Berichtes kennen, wenn es möglich ist.
Ich muss know the intention of the message to be conveyed. I should have questions, should be well prepared. Have I got the questions in advance? Is my statement clear and simple in its wording? Is it brief? Is it short? Better 30 seconds than 90 seconds. And then the personality is another point. Personality of the people in front of the telly.
So,
because I have to convey the message, people tend to view my outer appearance, to have a look at my personality. So then, let's try to do our best to convey the message the best way possible. I thank you.
Ganz herzlichen Dank, Herr Thiersch.
Mr. Thiersch, many, many thanks for this reality check.
Glaube ich, nötig ist.
I think which is quite useful. Maybe it's
besser zu machen,
oder could we improve the light in the room?
Ich kann relativ schlecht gucken. Doch jetzt
it's hard for me to recognize. Are there any questions or contributions for discussion?
Bitte, Herr Bricker.
Mr. Bricker.
Das ja sehr schön dargestellt aus der Fernsehsicht.
Very well presented from the point of view of the TV channels, but we have new media, we have YouTube, we have Internet. What's your point of view?
In
YouTube, you can be longer for your message. Could that change the world entirely? Because we know that there are less TV spectators among young people. Internet is a big chance, but the question is how can you be found and what is the mix in the Internet? Climate change, try and look up climate change Saxony, and then you will have 50 videos. You cannot see who's behind the video. So there is a good chance, if it is possible to find qualified statements and actual expertise, maybe that known faces, popular faces can be seen in order to give the information. There might be interviews for the internet. My interest is whether there's actually expertise behind, or is it just a small talk without any further consequences. I think there's also an issue of quality. It's very important to introduce quality into internet portals. There may be people just wanting to see funny pictures or fascinating pictures about climate change, but it's also about information and message. How can we actually use them, those portals, to convey good information, qualified information, however shortened down to the lowest necessary extent? Longer statements in television presentations tend to cause people to zip away, because people do not actually like to listen to to lengthy statements. So you will have to find a balance.
Heinz.
You said it's the spectator who wants it. The micro doesn't work. So.
Nee, das muss über das Mikro laufen, sonst können die Übersetzer nichts hören.
Hallo.
Jetzt geht's.
Okay.
Da hat einen Wackelkontakt oder was?
Sie hatten gerade. Sie hatten gerade gesagt, der Zuschauer will das so.
It's the spectator's wish or will.
Frage. So that's a critical point. Der Deutschlandfunk hat ja
Deutschlandfunk Radio
guten Erfolg mit einem
broadcast
anderen
has another concept and is successful.
And
it's now a question I have.
Is it,
are there different points of view? Is there something in between? So longer statements anyway. I didn't say that it's the wish or will of the spectator, but I said for such a news show, a longer statement is a kind of kicking out tool, because the spectator will zap away. They want people to stay along, to stay online, on TV. Portals like Dreisat, other TV channels, Phoenix, Deutschlandfunk Radio broadcast. These are portals for a certain type of listeners or spectators, but they are well educated, academic style people, but the largest portion is not that type.
Or, also,
you actually choose Phoenix or Deutschlandfunk Radio broadcast in order to get information, get good explanations. But the other portals, the other TV channels, that is, we have another type of spectators, and people tend not to be so willing to accept lengthy statements or longer statements. Of course, we have certain focus explanations in political or scientific items, topics, but always restricted, limited. We have a new time. People tend to have not enough time, and that is why we have to put the most possible into short statements for radio and TV broadcasts. And there are only certain educational channels like Phoenix where parliamentary sessions are actually broadcasted. Very tricky also for me to explain with very few words a complicated matter. I do not know what certain meteorological background knowledge cannot be assumed, or I do not assume it's, or you have to find the middle. And of course we want the TV channel wants to keep
Die will man ja behalten. Und nicht, dass nach 10 Minuten der Sendung 400.000 raus sind.
And we do not want to lose 400.000 of them because this is boring, it's lengthy. You may of course argue, but we still have 100.000 who actually listened to our statement. So far, I'm not actually TV, but so far as I see TV people, they actually have another way of thinking. They want to have the quota. They want to have a certain share of spectators.
Ja. Ganz herzlichen Dank, auch wenn das natürlich eine ernüchternde Bilanz ist.
Although we see it's a kind of disappointing partly, I'd like to add a remark on my behalf as to the university background. Also in universities for many years we have been focused on, so to say, volume masses instead of quality, with the intention to reduce the number of people leaving without being graduated. So we as a society tend to be quite self-conceiving to a certain extent.
Thanks,
Mr. Thiersch, for your highly interesting presentation.